Okay, let's start the quiz. The first question is in front of you. The result of some test on a colorless liquid X are shown. The liquid has a boiling point 102 degrees Celsius. Universal indicator turns green. Universal indicator turns green. Okay, universal indicator is used for identify acid and bases that turns green. And boiling point is given to you. Can you tell me what is the substance among this? Okay, you have to think it is related to the chapter 1. This question is related to chapter 1. If you think, you can get the answer. Boiling point is 102 degrees Celsius. Okay. So, answer of this question is... Okay, let's see how many of you can do this. Okay, my dear student, answer was D. Okay, if you remember, I gave you, do you remember? I don't remember whether I explained that in other groups, in other classes. If INR people remember, I told you, whenever you add impurity in water, whenever you add impurity in water, boiling point increases or decreases? Boiling point increases or decreases? Tell me, boiling point increases. So you had 102 degrees Celsius. So mostly it would be the salt water, NaCl aqueous. And second thing, they have given green color. So green color in universal indicator is because of the neutral solution. NaCl is neutral in neutral. You all know that what is the color of universal indicator if it was acid? If it was acid, what will be the color? Yes, acid gives red color and base gives blue color. So the intuition they have given, please mute your mic. If base was given, then it was a blue color, but they have given green color means it is a neutral solution. So you have to think like that. Okay. So answer is D. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. If anyone has any, should I show the question? Should I show the question? No? Okay. 1 minute. I thought it's clear to all of you, but one student has asked. This is the question. Okay. So you can see here, boiling point is 102. So answer is sodium chloride salt solution. On adding the impurity, if you remember, I explained in the class. If on adding impurity, boiling point increases. So boiling point goes from 100 to 102. Universal indicator turns green. So universal indicator turns green in a neutral solution. Only neutral solution you have this. Ethanol boiling point is 78 degrees Celsius. This is not the answer. You know that ethanol is there in your, like alcohol is there in your sanitizer. Alcohol boiling point are very less. That's why they are highly volatile. That's why they are highly volatile. Okay. So answer is D. I hope you understood this. Okay, fine. So, next question is, okay, Abhish, who is leading? Abhishek NPR, NPS INR. Good, Abhishek. Okay, moving to the next question. A blue solid X is soluble in water. Which method is used to obtain a pure solid X from aqueous solution? Blue solid X is soluble in water. Which method is used to obtain a pure solid X from aqueous solution? You have 20 more seconds, 25 seconds. Okay, students, please don't discuss any other thing. Which process you will use to purify the liquid, to get the pure crystal? Okay, answer for this question is B. 45 of you got the right answer. Okay, so answer was very easy. Okay, anyone has any doubt, please ask. Do you have, okay, why? So, see. Question number 2 is this. A blue solid X. See, solid is given to you and which is soluble in water. Okay, water soluble. Just take an example of salt solution. If you have a salt solution, how can you get the pure crystal of solid? I explained you this in class. Do you remember I explained this in class? If you have a salt solution and you keep on heating the salt solution, after some time you will get the crystal. And when you get the crystals, stop. So that is known as crystallization. Just remove the whole water and then leave it for cooling. That process is known as crystallization. I explained this thing when I was explaining you the saturated, unsaturated, super saturated solutions. So crystallization is the technique used. Any doubt, student, to obtain the pure salt? Okay, what will happen if I ask you one question? Let's say I have the sugar here. Let's say I have a sugar solution. And if I keep on heating, and I'm not stopping the burner, and if heat goes continuously, what will happen? Are you going to get the sugar? Are you going
to
get the
sugar?
Yes, tell me.
So you won't get the sugar because the sugar will start it'll also start caramelizing as well.
Yeah, so you will get a black powder in that case. So no one can say it is like only evaporation. The process, that's why we will not get sugar. If we want to get the pure solid, we need to use the chromatography. Understood? Okay, fine. Anyone has any doubt, please ask. No doubts? Okay, we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, students, I would tell you once more that please don't write an unnecessary messages, because I am not able to read if someone really has any doubt in this. So please don't discuss anything other than what we are doing here, other than the questions. If you have doubt in questions, you can write it there. Question number 3. A mixture is separated using the apparatus shown. To a mixture you have, you can see there is a funnel, filter paper you have. Filter paper and funnel and mixture is poured into that. What is this mixture? Now you have to think, what is there in that mixture? I would help you a little bit.
So the font is very small.
Like that. Sir, it's very small. That's why I'm reading. A mixture is separated using the apparatus shown. You have a container, there is a funnel, there is a filter paper, and mixture is poured over that. What is the mixture? Aqueous copper chloride and copper, A option. Aqueous copper chloride and sodium chloride, B option. Ethane and methane, C option. Ethanol and water, D option. Okay, so most of you have answered it right only. Just see how to do this question. It is again a very easy question. See, okay, just a minute. Third question is this one. A mixture is separated. So apparatus is given. You know, you need to, that mixture can only be separated which is a combination of some solid and some liquid. Which is a combination of solid and liquid, that only will get retained over the filter paper. Okay, aqueous copper chloride and copper is the only answer because copper is solid and copper chloride is solution. Copper chloride is solution. Copper chloride and NaCl will not work because both are solution. Both are solution. Ethane and methane, both are gases. Ethanol and water, both are liquid. Won't work. Understood? Could I move to next one? Okay. Okay, next question is, so first we'll see the leaderboard, who is leading now. Raghav and all those who are talking, please, those who are chatting on this chat box, please don't do that. I am not able to read the messages. Okay, so we'll go see the next question. Ethanol is made by fermentation. Ethanol is made by fermentation. How is the ethanol obtained from the fermentation mixture? Ethanol is nothing but the alcohol. It is made by the fermentation. How the ethanol obtained from the fermentation mixture?
Chicken.
Please mute your mic. Okay, most of you are right. You know, fermentation is the process of preparation of ethanol with the help of, let's say, you have the, you must have heard that. Okay, who can tell? You have a glucose, okay? Glucose you have, and there are the enzymes called as yeast, or enzymes are used to ferment the glucose and get the ethanol and carbon dioxide. This process is used, and in that process, the way of obtaining alcohol is fractional distillation. Fractional distillation is used in those processes where the boiling point difference is very less. When the mixture has the components and those components have a very less boiling point difference, then only where we use the fractional distillation. Okay, this is the last warning, students. If you keep on chatting here, I'll remove all of you, those who are chatting. Please don't chat. If you have anything related to the questions, then only you can write there, okay? So, Arthur is leading. Okay, next question. Which two methods can be used to separate a salt from its solution in water? Which two methods can be used to separate a salt from its solution in water? Crystallization, decanting, distillation, filtration. You know, all these four processes you have already learnt in your class 8 or 7. You know all these things. What is the distillation? What is decantation? What is filtration? What is crystallization? Okay, so what processes we can use to separate salt from its solution? Please underline, please read this word, salt from its solution. Okay, so think, what is the answer? Okay, answer is B, very good. Answer is B. 37 have answered. Okay, students, I told you one process I already told you in previous question. If you want to separate, you can use the crystallization. One process is also distillation. Distillation will also give you the salt and water. Yes? Any doubt, students? Okay, Tanvi settling is sedimentation and removing the. Okay, fine. Any doubt? Why not decantation? Very good question, Bharat. That's why I told you. Please read the word solution. Decantation is used where you have an insoluble thing. Then that insoluble thing settle down. If you have a sugar and water, so in that sugar solution, your sugar will not get settled down. Yes? Did you understand? One student asked Bharat. Did you understand? Okay, good. Moving to the, okay, we'll see the next question. Okay, fastest is Monisha. Good, Monisha. Saurabh is, okay, Arthur is not leaving his place. Okay, now still we have so many questions. Okay, this is really I know that the font is very small, but listen to me carefully. A solid mixture contains an ionic salt, X, okay, and a covalent organic compound, Y, okay. Now, two students suggest methods of separating the mixture as shown. In method 1, shake with water and then filter it. Method 2 is shake with ethanol and then filter it. Which method of separation are likely to work? I want to tell you one thing in this question, that you all know that like dissolves like. I used this word many times in class. I want to help you here.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I couldn't read the thing properly.
I read now.
Yes,
the solid. Okay, it's fine.
Sir, it was hard to connect with the reading, sir.
That's why I read the question.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, can you read a little fast? Like, not so slow.
Okay, fine. Okay.
Sir, any chance you can increase the font?
Okay, one thing. Listen. From next time, I read the question. You could have
used quite less for the question.
Okay,
yes,
fine.
Sir.
Okay, no problem. First, okay, we'll see the question. Just see what whether you understood or not. I think time was less for all of you. Okay, so that's not an issue. Now see, the question was this. Can you see my screen now or should I zoom in? Is it fine? A solid mixture contains solid X and organic solid Y. This solid is nothing but X and Y. And this X and Y, there are two methods. Two students are there. One is suggesting that add water and filter. Other is suggesting add ethanol and filter. You know, ethanol is a organic compound. And your water is all, water is inorganic. Okay, as I told you, like dissolves like. Like dissolves like means water will dissolve the salt, ionic salt. Because water is a polar compound, ionic salt is a polar compound. So water is, you all know that NaCl get dissolved in water. Because water is a polar, it dissolves the NaCl. Similarly, ethanol can dissolve the covalent compound, that is nothing but an organic compound. Ethanol cannot, if you put a salt and ethanol, you know, it can't dissolve that. Salt and ethanol can't form a solution. So, what will happen if you put a water on this filter paper? Sorry, 1 minute. Okay, see. If you put filter paper here, see. If you put filter paper and water, so the solution which is we call at like a filtrate. Filtrate will have your salt and water, and your organic compound will get deposited here. This is an organic compound. That is organic compound, it is nothing but Y. If you do like this, your Y will come with the filtrate. Y plus ethanol will come here, and here you will get the salt. So both the ways are fine, both the ways are correct to separate X and Y. Okay students, if you have any doubt, please ask, because there are so many messages. If you have doubt now, right now type your doubt if you have any doubt. No doubt, sure. Okay, this concept will be used in other questions also. So if you have any doubt, please ask now only. Okay, fine. So moving to the next one. Okay, I'll read the question fast and now from now onwards.
So you can show your PPT. So it's clear in that.
Okay. So okay, you let me know whenever you feel like font is very small, I will show my PPT in that case, okay? But you have to tell me at that time only.
So can you just show it, sir?
No, then we have to start this thing also, no? In Mentimeter also. Okay, see, all questions are not like that. If there is some question which has a really small font, I will definitely go for the PPT in that case, okay?
So, okay. But some of us couldn't see the options either, so that was hard to.
Pardon?
So we couldn't see the options clearly.
Okay, fine. Okay, now you will not face this issue. Let's move to the next question. I'll read question for you. Please listen to me, and I'll read options also. Naphthalene and iron pilings cannot be. Okay, there is a word cannot, okay? Cannot is very small in font. Naphthalene and iron pilings cannot be separated by the method of solvent extraction, sublimation, magnetic separation, and filtration. Please mute your mic, all of you, please mute your mic. Cannot, there is a word cannot, okay? Naphthalene and iron filings cannot be separated by method of solvent extraction, sublimation, magnetic separation, and filtration. I told you cannot, there is a word cannot. Monisha, why you didn't listen? Why is cannot small? I will tell you why later. Okay, then if you are marked wrong means you have made the mistake. Okay, 33 students. Someone asked me, sir, why you have written the word cannot or why cannot is small. Actually, this question was MCQ based. There were the multiple correct answers, but to make the but I wanted to give this question to you so that you understand the concept. So I made it the single correct. Okay, now see what is there in the question. Just 1 minute. Question is this. Naphthalene and iron cannot be separated by method of, you know, solvent extraction. Solvent extraction is nothing. Let's say naphthalene. I told you naphthalene is an organic compound. Like dissolves like. Organic compound. Iron filings are the metal. If you put some organic substance, you can dissolve naphthalene in that. But iron filing cannot be dissolved. So this is the only method. Okay, this is the one of the method. They have asked cannot be separated. This, by this method you can separate. Second is sublimation. Sublimation you can separate because naphthalene are the naphthalene is sublimable substance. Magnetic separation can be used, but filtration won't work because both are solid. How you can separate? Both are solid. Answer is D. No. Understood? Okay, Tanvi, what doubt you have? Please. Yes, Tanvi, please ask what doubt you have. Yes, no, you can't separate it by D. That was the question. You cannot separate. You know, if you have a naphthalene balls, these are the naphthalene balls. And let's say you have the iron balls. Iron balls are, let's say I am representing with the brown color. So if you put in the filter paper also, how can you separate them? It cannot be separated by filter paper. Understood? So filtration is not the technique. So this is the answer. They have asked cannot be separated. Tanvi, is it clear? Tanvi, please respond. Okay, fine. Yeah, okay, thank you. Now we are moving to the next question. If anyone still has any doubt, please ask. Okay. Next question we'll see. First we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, good Monisha. Next question. Okay, very font size is very small. Yes, I'll show. Yes, I'll show it. Wait. Okay, so question is this. Please read the question carefully. Methanols, yes, this is the question. Please read it carefully. Methanol, CH3OH and ethanol are miscible liquids. Which diagram shows the apparatus that is used to obtain methanol from mixture of ethanol and methanol?
So could you scroll down and show us the options?
Oh, these are option only A, B, C, D. These diagrams are option. Over?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, fine. Now I'll show you the how to do the question. Okay, fine. What is the answer of this question? Tell me. It's very easy question.
So B.
Is the answer. Yes, B is the answer. Why B? Because these are the liquids which are having a almost equal boiling point, or boiling point difference is very less, and these two are the liquids only. So A we can't use, because A is used for solid and liquid separation. B we can use. Only heating won't work, because both will evaporate. And the last option is used. The last option, why I gave this question, you know, last option is very interesting. Whenever there is a water in any salt and you want to remove that, you use this technique. I am again repeating, whenever there is a water and you want to remove that, you use this technique. What you do, you provide heat from this end. So what will happen? Water will evaporate and report to this tub. It will report to this tub. And then later on, it will report in over the test tube by the downward displacement of water. Or if there is some oxide, let's say copper oxide is there. If there is a copper oxide and you want to remove the oxygen from copper oxide, just heat it. So oxygen will report on the top of this. Understood? Students? Did you understand? Did you understand this? Okay, moving to the next one. Okay, fine. Please read the question carefully. Okay, should I show in the PPT or is it visible?
Yes, sir.
PPT.
Okay.
PPT.
One minute. I'll show it. 1 minute. Okay, see. A mixture of sulfur and iron filings needs to be separated. I think you can read the question, so I'm not reading it. Please tell me the answer. Okay, how many of you have done? Okay, so people, easy. Okay, good. Still, it's a small font. baby font. Okay, should I zoom in? Thank you, Gandhar.
Sir, this is fine, but the real question font is small.
Okay.
Sir, time's up.
Okay, thank you, student. So, what is the answer of this question? First, tell me, do you have any doubt? I'm not able to see the leaderboard. Do you have any doubt? Answer is B. Do you have any doubt? If anyone has any doubt, please ask. Okay, no. Oh my God, so many answers. Okay, please, everyone should not. Okay, no doubts.
Yes. I put in the option B, but then the software shows wrong answer.
No, I think answer. Okay, let's see what is the answer. Sulfur is their solubility in water. Okay, they have given. What is the possible technique for sulfur and iron filings? Using water, can you do that? No, both are not soluble in water. You know, you can use only that technique which can dissolve one thing and other remain insoluble. Like using a carbon disulfide. Carbon disulfide is, again, it is a non-polar, it will dissolve the sulfur. I told this thing in chapter 1, I told you sulfur can dissolve, carbon disulfide can dissolve sulfur, but it can't dissolve iron filing. So this is the correct way. And using the magnet will attract the iron filings but not the sulfur. This is also correct. So answer is B only. Any doubt? Okay, we'll move to the next question. First, we'll see the leaderboard. Okay, 40 students have marked it right. Good students. Now, we are moving to the next one. Rishabh is leading. Srijan goes for KRM. Very good, Srijan. Okay. Next question is in front of you. Should I show you PPT again? PPT or this
thing? Yes, sir. So PPT.
PPT, okay, fine. Fine. PPT is in front of you. Please write the answer. A mixture 1 contains sand and water. Mixture 2 contains sand, salt and water. Which method of separation could be used to obtain each of the required product from each mixture? Okay, this question is very good question. Okay, please read the option carefully and then answer.
So my screen has hung, sir. I'm not able to answer.
Tanya, what to do now? Please refresh it. There is only one option. Please refresh it and do. Yeah, these questions are very big. You need to understand that. But while I explain you this, okay, I think it times up, yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is, so do you need, okay, anyone wants explanation?
So the answer is D.
Fine. Anyone want explanation? Please tell me yes or no. Yes, okay. 1 minute. Sir, no. Anyone who wants? Okay, yeah, yes, someone has written yes. Contain salt and water. Salt and sand and water, salt and water. To obtain the sand, okay, try to understand. You want to recover the sand from the water. You know the filtration is the best technique. Please put your mic. Students. Raghav, or those who, please don't on your microphone. So, obtain sand filtration is the best technique, you know. And by the filtration, what you are going to get? So, filtration are there in option C and D. Okay, fine. Next is, to obtain water also filtration is best. Why you want to go for the distillation? Distillation is used when the boiling point, if there is no other option left with you, filtration is the best technique. Okay, so by filtration you can separate both. Salt and water. Salt, I told you, crystallization will give you the salt. But now why I told this question is very important. Whenever you want to recover the solvent, I'm repeating my statement again. Whenever you want to recover the solvent, you go for the distillation. Because in the distillation, there is a tube. If you have checked, one question I gave in which the distillation apparatus was given. So there is a tube in the distillation chamber. this tube will recover all your solvent. This tube will recover all your solvent. That's why answer is D. Is it clear? Someone asked Satyam or someone asked this question. Is it clear, Shivam? Okay, thank you. Fine. Moving to the next one. Okay, good. So leaderboard, just we'll see the leaderboard. Oh, Sweden is fastest. Oh, Zagreb is leading. Okay. Please read the question carefully. The table gives the solubility of four substances. Do you need? Can you read this or should I show? Sir, PPT. Okay, fine. PPT. No problem. I will show it. Yes. Tables give the solubility of four substances in ethanol and in water. The mixture containing all four substances added to the ethanol. Stirred and filtered. The solid residue is added to water. Stirred and filtered. Filtrate and evaporated is evaporated to dryness, leaving the white solid. Which is the white solid? Please take your time and answer this question, okay? Jagar, please put your mic on mute. Okay, please let me know if time gets over.
Sir, time's up.
Okay, time's up. Okay, see, question is very easy and it's a very good question. So, Tanvi, what do you mean by Mahatma Gandhi? I didn't understand that. Something you have written here. There. Okay, so table gives the solubility of four substances. Okay, fine. Four substances are there. Okay, now we will write A, B, C, D, let's say. Four substances in ethanol in water. Now, a mixture containing all four substances added to ethanol. If I put into ethanol, ethanol is some solvent and stirred and filtered. So I put into the ethanol. Okay, I stirred it and I filtration will, let's say I filter it. Okay, once I filter it, what they are saying, the solid residue is added to water. Okay, I have taken this thing to the water, not the down thing. This means that the thing which I am taking is insoluble in ethanol. Is it clear? Because they have said that the solid residue is added to water, stirred and filtered. So now I am adding this solid. I am adding this solid into water. This is the water. Okay? And it is mixed properly. And in the next process, the filtrate is evaporated to dryness. Now again, the filtrate. Here you are using the filtration again. Okay, now filtrate you are taking to the dryness. This you are taking for the dryness. Leaving a solid behind. Now you got some solid. This solid is white solid. Now tell me what is that nature of white solid. So I think you understood this question. That white is obtained by the residue of the filtered ethanol. Residue of filtered ethanol means this solid is definitely not soluble in ethanol. So I will write insoluble in ethanol. Insoluble in ethanol. And this solid is passed through the filter paper. See this. This means solid is soluble in water. Soluble in water. Okay, what is the answer then? Solid is soluble in water. Water is this soluble and insoluble. Answer is B. Please check. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I hope you understood this question. Okay, we'll see the leaderboard first. 22 people have answered it right only. So I think you understood this question. If anyone has any doubt, please ask. Okay, fine. So we are moving to the next question. Are you all ready? Any doubt? No? Okay. Please read the question carefully. PPT? Do you need? Okay. Please read the question carefully. A student carries out an experiment to prepare pure magnesium sulfate crystal. This is again a very good question. I have given more time for this question. Okay, because this is very good question, please take your time and answer this question. Vibha, why are you discussing all those things? Vibha? Okay. Should I explain?
So time is not yet up.
Okay, fine. Sorry. Please let me know.
So time's up.
Okay, fine. So question is very easy, you know. A student carries out an experiment to prepare pure magnesium sulfate crystal. Okay, anyone want me to explain this question? Please tell first. What's the answer? Okay, I think you must have got the answer. It is, I think it's the answer is filtration. C. Yes. How to do this question? Okay. Anyone has any doubt? Tell me. 1 minute. Please mute your mic. No doubt. Anyone who wants me to explain? No one? Should I move to the next question? Okay. Yes, next question. Please explain. Someone has asked. See, magnesium carbonate, when add to the dilute sulfuric acid, H2SO4, this is the sulfuric acid. Okay, now what they have given? He adds magnesium carbonate until no precipitate. Now this is very, very important question. He add magnesium carbonate. This person is keep on adding the magnesium carbonate in this container, in this beaker. He is keep on adding. Which process should he use the next stage? Why I put this question in the today's class? You have to think like what will be the next step. Next stage will be what? You know, magnesium carbonate when he is going to add, after some time, they have given that he will add till no more react. So after some point of time, you know what will happen? When no more magnesium will react, how you are going to detect that? Actually, some magnesium will get deposit here. Some magnesium carbonate will get deposit. That's how he will going to know that no more magnesium is dissolving. You know, this is actually practically based question. Practically what we do, we keep on adding magnesium carbonate. Once we notice that, please put your mics on mute. Once you notice that no more magnesium carbonate is dissolving, then you stop the process. Now, when you want, what is the next process? The next process is you need to filter this. You need to filter this so that you can remove this magnesium carbonate and you get this. This is nothing but magnesium sulfate. You can get the magnesium sulfate, pure magnesium sulfate. Understood? This is the process to make one salt from the other. Here you use the magnesium carbonate to prepare magnesium sulfate. But the first process is to filter. This is nothing but extra magnesium carbonate.
So I put filtration, I didn't get, it's showing as wrong answer.
it's showing wrong. Is it? Are you sure? All of you are getting wrong answer.
Sir, it happened to me also, sir, before.
No, 1 minute. We'll see that. Okay, fine. See.
Sir, I asked the question and I got it right.
Okay, I think then what can I do? Tell me, students. Answer you can see in front of you. It's C only. Only 9 students. Oh my God. Okay, students, did you really understood this question? Did you really understand this question or not? Anyone who still has, anyone has any doubt? Please, no, now I understood. Okay, anyone who still has any doubt, sir, why do we keep on adding? Yes, it is given in the question. Very good question. See, someone has asked, sir, why we keep on adding this? I told you, you are using magnesium carbonate to prepare magnesium sulfate. And my dear student, how you will get to know that all sulfuric acid has reacted? How you got to know? You keep on adding. At one point of time, your salt will stop dissolving. It is same like you are adding sugar in water. If you add sugar in water, till some time it will keep on dissolving. But at one point, when you add a single sugar crystal, that will report in the bottom. That will not get dissolved. That is how you get to know that this is the saturation limit. After this, you can't dissolve a single sugar crystal. Similarly, you keep on adding and once you get to know that no more carbonate is dissolving, that is how you get to know the whole sulfuric acid has reacted. Now no more sulfuric acid is left in the container. So this is the way we convert one salt into another. Understood or not? Someone asked this question. Did you understand this? I mean, we can also add limited amount and filter. No. Okay, listen, Bharat. If you add the limited amount, let's say you add 5 gram. But that 5 gram is getting dissolved completely. Then what you are going to filter? It is dissolved. It is same like, let's say 36 gram can be dissolved in 20 degree Celsius temperature. 36 gram of sugar can be dissolved. Now, if you dissolve 25 gram at 20 degree Celsius, your 25 gram will completely dissolve. Then what you do with the filter paper in that case? Everything will pass from that. Understood? Tanvi, you are disturbing class, I'm telling you. Please don't type anything. Okay, it gets dissolved, got it, sir. Okay, any other doubt? No? Fine. Please try to understand. I can't read the messages if you keep on chatting. Okay. So next question is in front of you. Please read the question carefully before answering. Okay. Which of the following pair of gases cannot be separated by diffusion method? Diffusion, you know, I explained you when one gas goes from one place to another, or a higher concentration thing goes to the lower concentration, that is called as diffusion. You have 1 minute 15 seconds left. You have to think properly which gas can be diffused. How you can separate? There is a purpose of giving you the more time in this question. Monisha, you have to think. There is a sulfur dioxide and hydrogen, CO2 and N2O. You have a little bit idea of periodic table, little bit idea. What comes first, what comes after that, until atomic number 10. I think all of you have idea till atomic number 10. If you know till atomic number 10 only, you can answer this question very easily. Okay, Monisha, then you can answer. How to use, I explained in the class. You think how diffusion can help you separating two things. Okay, yeah, me too. What you are saying to Moi Aisu Ausi, either you, people are disturbing, yeah, or write in English only. Okay, so answer for this question is CO2 and N2O. Let's see how many of you have answered this. Oh, good. 22. Fine. See, the question was very easy. You know what was there in the question? Okay, you know, very easy question. Why? I told you, if you remember, hydrogen, helium, lithium. Okay, hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon. You'd need till this only. You know, carbon, the diffusion, if you remember, I explained that thing. Diffusion is nothing but movement of particles, movement of molecules. Okay? So, if the molecule is bigger, let's say you have this much, the size of molecule is this much, and size of molecule is this much, which will run fast? Tell me, which will run fast, A or B? Which will run fast, A or B? A will run fast. Okay, someone has written B also. So A will run fast, B will not run fast, because it is, A is a small. Okay, now if A is a small particle, that, can I say that after some time A will report here but B will reach here only? So by this way you can separate A and B. By this way you can separate A and B. This is nothing but separation. Similarly, you have to think in gases also. Which gas is having a huge molecular mass difference and which is having the same molecular mass? If mass is same, they won't be separated by diffusion. You see, the only this option where the carbon is having combined with two oxygen and two nitrogen is combining with oxygen. In this case, the mass are same. CO2 mass is, those who know little bit about the atomic number, this is 6. Atomic number 6, oxygen atomic number is 8. So mass of CO2 is atomic number, just multiply it with 2. Carbon 6 multiplied by 2, okay, it is nothing but 12. 12 is the mass of carbon, and 32 is the mass of oxygen, that is 44. Mass of N2O is nitrogen mass. Nitrogen atomic number 7, mass is 14. 14 plus 14 plus oxygen mass is atomic number 8, mass is 16. 16. It is 44. In this case only you can't separate through the diffusion, because both will run with same speed. You can't separate them. Students, did you understand this? How? What how? Someone has written how. Nitya, you have written how. Nitya, do you have any doubt? Okay. Fine. So we'll move to the next question. Okay, students, please don't type unnecessary messages. Okay, now who is leading? Very good, Srijan. Now we are going to have a next question. Please read the question carefully. Okay, you need PPT or is it fine?
So we need PPT.
Yes, a constituent of a heterogeneous mixture contains XYZ. In this mixture, if mixture is XY, taken X can be separated using magnetic separation from Y. If Y and Z mixture is taken, it can be separated using distillation. Which of the following mixture can be XYZ? Diya, Pratik, can you please stop?
So after this, are there any more questions?
One more question we have.
So time's up.
Okay, fine. Answer for this question is A. Why A? This mixture, considering a heterogeneous mixture XYZ, XY can be separated by magnetic separation. Means, one should be magnetic. So, iron is magnetic, salt is not magnetic. Y and Z mixture is taken can be used as distillation. Distillation will be used when there is a salt and water. If there is a salt and water, something is soluble. Soluble thing is, whenever there is a soluble thing, we use the distillation. So, salt and water is there. Answer is A. Students, if you have any doubt, please ask. Any doubt? No? Okay, students. Now we are going to do the last question. Iron magnetic, yes. Iron is magnetic. Cobalt is magnetic. Nickel is magnetic. Oh, good. Okay, now the last question. You can read it in your mentimeter only. Greasy spots can be removed from clothes by evaporation, sublimation, fractional distillation, dissolving in a suitable solvent. Oh, good, Tanavi. Good, Aditya. Oh, 1.33. Oh, very good. Okay, so last 10 seconds. I think you can relate this question with your practical. Practical, you see that when there is a greasy spot, how you remove that? Okay, that is nothing but the solvent extraction. Oh, three students have made the mistake. It is solvent extraction, but still it's a good graph. Okay, now we are going to see the result and tell me, according to you, who won the game? Who won this quiz? Tell me fast. Okay, Jagrav, Srijan, Monish, Janish. Okay, fine, Srijan, Jagrav. Only three votes we are getting. Okay, just give me 1 second. I'll show you the result. Okay, Jagrav, there are too many votes for Jagrav. Okay, see, let's see who won this. And the result goes. Okay, I think it's Jagrav only. Oh, good, Jagrav. Good, congratulations. Okay, students, hope you learned something today about the separation technique. Yes or no? Have you learned something? Okay, good, good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you, student. We'll again have this centum on next week. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, next time, please increase the font, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Sir.
Thank you, sir.
Someone was saying something. Yes.
Please increase the font.
Okay, my dear student, you know, whenever the questions are big, whenever the questions are covering more area, I can't increase font, otherwise it will... You can't read the full question. Understood?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Bye. Thank you.